Some of my earliest memories were of my mom and dad telling me that a woman could do anything. I had the best example in my own mom because when I was 11 years old, she became one of the first female mayors in Canada. And my dad was her campaign manager and biggest champion. In 1985, when I was an art clean student at a downtown law firm, we'd all been brought together in a boardroom to meet with the managing partner. And the managing partner began by saying, "Do you know why women will never succeed in business? It's because they're never willing to put their careers ahead of their families." I was stunned by this. And I told him, "You're wrong. I can tell you many examples of women who have been successful in business and they've not sacrificed their families." And I completely reject the notion that there's only one path for a woman to succeed, and that's being more like a man. We have such an incredible pipeline of talent coming through, but they're different. They are making decisions based on organizations and whether or not they align with their values. And I think leaders need to make sure that they are out there, they're talking to these generations that are coming through. And when we continue to have leadership that truly values, understands, and respects what it means to be different, wow, that's where the magic happens.